we just witnessed the greatest NBA duel of all time. Now think about that. Murray versus Mitchell was better than Bird versus Magic, Pierce versus LeBron, even Iverson versus Carter. In a mesmerizing 7-game battle, Jamal Murray averaged 31.5 points per game, while Donovan Mitchell averaged 36.2. So in this video, since it's clear that we've seen the emergence of two future superstars, let's get into how the Spider and the Blue Arrow went at each other all series long. I'm Adam, this is D-Flow Hoops, welcome if you're new and if you're a subscriber already. If you want to see more NBA stories plus predictions and hot takes, hit subscribe and turn on notifications. Trust me, you're not going to want to miss my playoff content I've got on the way. Since college, when Murray was at Kentucky and Mitchell was at Louisville, the two rising phenoms have had an intriguing rivalry, but nothing could have expected us for the mesmerizing back-and-forth clash that just took place. By putting the team on their back for the majority of the 7 games, Jamal and Donovan displayed for the basketball world that they'll be perennial all-stars well into the 2020s. I have to confess, D-Mitch completely proved me wrong, as in my round one prediction, I did predict Denver would win the series, but my reasoning for that was very off. Here's what I have to say.
With two-way players like Jeremy Grant, Torrey Craig, and recent standout rookie PJ Dozier, I think Denver game plans in on D-Mitch with those options and keep the Jazz all-star in check. And they beat the Jazz 4-2.
Seeming to use that disrespect given to him by yours truly as motivation, the Spider's overpowering speed, athleticism, and ball handling exposed every Jazz defender put in front of him. Mitchell didn't let up as the games progressed and played with a massive chip on his shoulder while consistently putting the team on his back. I was wrong on this one, and stunned Mitchell showed up in the way he did, and his superstar-like production gives me a newfound respect for him as a top player in this league. I've seen people relate him to this generation's Dwayne Wade, but to be honest, no one's reminded me of Kobe as much as Mitchell did in that blistering series he just had. In terms of his focus, poise, and leadership, the Mamba mentality from Donovan was on full display. Nothing exemplified that better than after he hit this clutch dagger in the face of Paul Millsap to secure his second 50-point game of the series, and then yelling, "I want this shit." With Denver's entire defensive game plan zoned in on him, you'd see the majority of NBA stars shy away in this situation. Yet Mitchell's relentlessly persistent will to win, mixed with his elite speed and newly polished jump shot, kept him confident and allowed him to get whatever he wanted, even with above-average wing defenders draped all over him. In addition to his vamped scoring repertoire, you could tell Mitchell's feel for the game in terms of how he picked his spots was on point. For the series, Mitchell posted 36.2 points per game on 53% shooting, including 51.5% from deep and 95% from the line. According to StatMuse, he's the first player in history to post at least 35 points on a shooting line of 50, 50, and 90 in a playoff run, albeit a short one for Utah, but one they should feel very good about heading into the offseason. They barely lost, and if Donovan's given the ball on that hectic final possession, the Jazz could have very well moved on to round two. Mitchell's eligible for a 5-year max extension this offseason, and the Jazz will without a doubt offer it to him the second they can. There's the argument to wait until next offseason, until he's an unrestricted free agent, so the Jazz can preserve a bit more 2021 cap space, but you can't forget, Utah lost Gordon Hayward by delaying his extension offer and doing the exact same thing, so they're not going to risk losing another star player. So more on Donovan coming up, but overall, Mitchell both completely proved me wrong, and more importantly, earned himself a massive payday this offseason. Given that brilliance from Donovan was matched with the mastery of Jamal Murray, the Nuggets-Jazz 7-game showdown from start to finish was absolute eye candy. Murray's shot creation was at a historically great level and ultimately was the driving force for why the Nuggets were able to edge out the series win. He struggled in Game 7 after running into Joe Ingles and aggravating his previously injured hamstring, but before that, the 23-year-old from Toronto was on an all-time great hot streak. In games 4-6, Jamal scored 50, 42, and 40. Only two players in NBA history to have scored more points over a 3-game span in the playoffs than Murray's 142 were Jerry West in the mid-60s and Michael Jordan in 1988. The latter's the greatest player of all time, while the former's depicted on the NBA logo, so some solid company. Seamlessly pulling up in either transition or pick and roll scenarios, Murray showed exactly why I ranked he and Jokic third in my recent top 10 duos video, and that's the fact that this guy shows up in the playoffs, is extremely clutch, and when he finds a rhythm, is debatably the best shot creator in our game. The Blue Arrow's release on his three-pointer defines fundamentally sound. His shooting off the dribble is Steph Curry-esque, and from there his slashing makes him the entire package offensively. Like Mitchell, the Kentucky product's got elite speed as well, but Murray's springiness isn't quite at Donovan's level. Making up for the lack of hops, though, Jamal perfectly baited defenders with his three-point shot, then consistently found ideal angles to finish at the rim dominantly. Now you'll see every broken record and historical feat set in this series that I haven't already mentioned, then I'll show you the classy sportsmanship plus a detailing of the extreme heart shown off from Jamal and Donovan. Mitchell and Murray scored, are you ready for this, 475 points in this series. That's the most combined points by opposing players in a single series in NBA history, topping the 463 points from Jerry West and John Havlicek going into the 2020 playoffs. All-time great Michael Jordan and fellow Hall of Famer Allen Iverson were the only players in NBA history to put up 250-point games in a single playoff series. Murray and Mitchell both just matched that, as the former Louisville Cardinal went for 57 points in Game 1 and 51 in Game 4, while Murray got to 50 in Games 4 and 6. Jamal Murray is the first player since Michael Jordan in the 1993 NBA Finals with three straight 40-point games in a postseason series. Jordan had four straight. And lastly, Game 4 was the first game in NBA postseason history that opposing players each reached 50 points. This game also made Jamal Murray the first Nuggets player to reach that mark in playoff history. I don't know about you, but I'm pretty sad this series has come to an end. Stinging Jazz fans, D-Mitch collapsed after Mike Conley missed the game winner, but rightfully there to pick him up was none other than Jamal Murray. In this moment, it felt like neither he or Mitchell had gotten the better of one another, and the two were just acknowledging each other's greatness. And here's how Murray gave Mitchell even more respect post-game.
It was an amazing duel. I mean, you just willed this team every game, win or lose. And he had that fight. And you got to show respect that we pay our respects to him. It was a great battle, and it's not going to be the only one either. And we expect to see each other a lot down in the future. And he raised him up, played the game, upraised his. And we go at it, and it's a whole lot of fun. And we bring the best out of each other.
What made this duel special in comparison to any other one-on-one clash we've ever seen in playoff history is how both competitors utterly laid their heart out. You could tell after every big play that each player's pride was at stake, and the competitiveness in these two individuals should set an example for every star in these playoffs. For NBA content on the go, including polls about upcoming games, player comparisons, as well as channel updates, follow me on Instagram at DFlowHoops. I may just follow you back. Plus, for a chance at next video shoutout, let me know your favorite part of Mitchell versus Murray. My name's Adam, call me D-Flow. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next video.